Hey traders, Roggy here, and I'm coming to you from the Florida Sun Studios today. I'm gonna be on Boom Bust, and you know, it's got me thinking about some of the things that are happening in the market right now. So what we're gonna be doing on this reboot of Simpler Exchange is talk more about these macro events that are happening right now and how you can find the trades to capitalize on them. So we're gonna do this in two parts typically. Now, sometimes I'm gonna be doing these from some kind of fun location, just give you an idea of what I'm doing here. When I'm filming the Boom Bust, you can see here I'm in the studio. There I am. And so I'm sitting in front of this green screen. It's a lot of fun. And so we're gonna be doing a whole lot more. I'm learning how to maneuver this selfie stick, which is always pretty fun too. So here I am, make-upped and ready to go. What's going on right now in the markets? Right now we have the Turkish lira that's definitely impacting what's going on in the equities markets, not only in the US, but abroad. We also have crude oil. I'm gonna be talking about crude oil on Boom Bust. So let me give you a lowdown on what I've researched and what I'll be talking about when I'm on television, because you know that's a 7 or 8 minute cut and I wanna give you guys a little bit more to work with. So what are we talking about? We're talking about what the Turkish lira is doing to the global economy at the moment. And I might have overblushed a little bit. I don't know. I think the way the lights hit me. The funniest things you pick up when you're getting ready to go on camera. So I think the overall markets right now are keyed in on a few things. First of all, what we have right now is certainly a certain concern about how much bank exposure there is right now to this Turkish lira event. We have Spanish banks and we have French banks right now with the most exposure to what's happening there. The other thing to remember is that we have also quite a bit of exposure in the US, limited to Goldman Sachs and Citigroup. So there's a couple of things I'm going to show you. How do you take advantage of playing the Turkish lira? How do you take advantage of playing Turkey? How do you take advantage of playing European bank stocks and US bank stocks? And when I dive into the charts and show you the setups, you'll notice that the macro environment is ultimately what makes me decide what it is I want to pull up on my charts. That's what's going to help me decide my watch list. All right, now crude is another narrative, and I think the crude oil narrative with what we're talking about on this particular show is that the stronger US dollar, which we can see that the euro has tanked in the last few days, the lira has been weakening, the Chinese have been very systematically devaluating the yuan since April. All this has brought the US dollar up. But there's also another thing that's happening. The FOMC has not let go of that very hawkish, possibly 150 basis points, what they say, 150 bips. 1.5% is what we're thinking we could see by the end of 2019. And the stock market is going to hate this. So what if Jerome Powell and company decide that they're going to possibly skip this December's rate hike? And what if they decide only to do maybe 2 or 3 rate hikes in 2019? The equities markets are going to like that, and that's going to help deal with what is right now a potential slowdown in the U.S. markets. There's a pretty good chance the U.S. is maybe 2 or 3 quarters behind China in terms of inflation flattening out and growth flattening out. You might say, Rog, what are you talking about? Amazon just hit all-time highs. What are you talking about, a slowdown? When you look at the data, and the data is not going to be an instant hit to the equities markets, but when you look at the data and the FOMC on the verge of almost, I think they'll refrain from this. Hopefully they'll come to their senses, but they might hike us right into a recession. And while all this is going on, we're wondering, you know, there was a Greenspan put in the markets back in the day. Some of you might remember Alan Greenspan and the Greenspan put. That was probably the very first plunge protection team. And the idea was Alan Greenspan would always make sure the equities markets would be supported by some sort of rate cut to keep equities higher. Well, what's happening now is Jerome Powell has a put of his own, possibly, and that's gonna be the bond play. Is Jerome Powell gonna come in and prevent the short-term bond rates from inverting with the longer term? That would be a disaster if near-term rates are higher than longer-term rates. That's this inversion that we're all hearing about. Is he going to prevent it? Right now, he doesn't seem all that concerned about it. And that's concerning the market, because one of the harbingers for recessions, although the timing is terrible, one of the harbingers for a potential recession is that yield inversion. It doesn't mean it's going to happen instantly, but it typically tends to be the canary in a coal mine. Again, timing is lousy. More likely, it's going to be there hiking, and there's this natural cyclical slowdown. Now, I have so much I want to share with you in these exchange episodes. Today, we're going to focus on, I think, Lira. You'll notice what I'm looking at with banks, European bank stocks, U.S. Bank, XLF, U.S. dollar, and that will be part of the conversation. All right, so now that you